Monrovia has just two public hospitals, and like many other medical facilities, one of them, JDJ, closed at the height of the Ebola epidemic. But activities at the hospital, which delivers emergency paediatric and maternity care, are gradually resuming. MSF is helping by supplying protective equipment and providing training on infection control measures.
The measures are being put in place. I think they're really going to improve our general condition in the hospitals. We're going to feel more confident. It will improve the kind of services that we give to these people, because one mistake will lead to your own death. So you have to be careful about what you do. But the most important thing is that I hope that it can be sustainable, that even after the outbreak, we should continue with these measures.
These measures require stringent triage of incoming patients to rapidly identify potential Ebola cases, wearing protective clothing adapted to the treatment being delivered, and complying with rigorous hygiene protocols. All these measures call for a radical change in behaviour, which can be difficult to implement when the epidemic appears to be abating.
Even health workers, some of them are letting their guards down. They think that people, they don't have a lot of cases around, but there's a need for us to know that one case remains an epidemic, so that people should continue to have all those preventive measures in place so that people cannot get reinfected and then start the circle all over again.
Along with assisting the resumption in medical activities, MSF teams continue to be actively involved in combating hemorrhagic fever. Oxford University launched a clinical trial at the beginning of January at ELWA 3, MSF's Ebola treatment centre in Monrovia, to assess the efficacy and tolerance of antiviral drug brimsodofidir. All patients contracting the virus can participate.